have been kicking butt, man. You what? They already over $400 this weekend. Yes. Already hit like two promotions, got 100% raise. Dude, how's that feel?
It was really awesome. I was expecting to have all that first weekend, and when I saw my first home maker, it was so awesome.
What do you feel like was like the biggest key for you to do well?
Honestly, just sticking to the program. You know, you kept telling me to follow the manual, so I did. You kept telling me to make sure to cut up 5 pieces of food and have fun. And that was all for me.
That's awesome. I'm so glad you implemented that. Look, I'll be very honest. You know, your friend Billy and your friend, you know, Joe, your friend Susie, you know, they all were obviously 10K grad partners, but not. It all started at this moment. So I just want to say congratulations on being a part of this PC. So this is your 10K Fast Track PC. I'm extremely excited. Typically, there's like one moment in every single person's Fast Track that there's like a decision that's made, and they decide to go really, really big. And today, hopefully, you know, is that moment for you. So, first and foremost, what is your favorite part about the job so far?
Like making sales has been so cool. It's like an adrenaline rush every single time. And I'm just having a lot of fun. A bunch of my friends are on the team, so.
Cool. And how do your parents feel about it?
My parents were very skeptical at first. You know, my mom told me this was a scam, but you know, like I shared all the sales I was making. Once I showed her the product, you know, like she definitely likes the product now. So, you know, when I get that first paycheck, I think she's gonna be pretty excited too.
Yeah, no, definitely. So, anyway, listen, tell me about a time in your life where you were behind. Okay, give me a time in your life where you were behind. Maybe you were in school or maybe you were in football. You know, for example, for like me, I went up to John Curtis and I played football at John Curtis. We were playing this hoover on national TV. You know, the lights were on. It was like, it was on, I don't know if you ever heard of Two-A-Days before, but it was on like MTV and I was freaking out. And we were losing 14-0 and at halftime. And the coach made a few adjustments and ended up winning 28-14 actually. But give me a time in your life where you were behind and all the odds were against you. And you came back and you ended up, you know, hitting your goal. Whether it's school, sports, whatever that may be.
Okay. I remember, you know, I played football in high school too, and kind of similar, not necessarily be on ESPN and on the national spotlight, but, you know, we were in a game and we were playing against Ronald, and we were down by 10 points, and there was 5 minutes left in the game. And we ended up coming back, and you know, like we successfully scored a touchdown, recovered an onside kick, and then went down and scored in the last, you know, about 20 seconds of the game, and then, you know, we stopped and won the game.
That's awesome, by the way. That's really, really cool. So, I mean, you know, let me ask you a question. In the beginning, right, when you were really, really behind, was there any doubt that you were going to be able to, you know, come back?
Yeah, I was definitely nervous. You know, there were parts of me that were thinking, you know, like, how can we do this? How can we do this? And I was trying to stay positive, but there's definitely parts of me that doubt.
Okay, and how important do you think staying positive, you know, play the factor into y'all coming back?
Definitely, it was really important. You know, obviously, I was out there with the team too, and you know, I made a couple of plays to get us going as well. So, if I would have doubted myself, I might not have called the ball, you know, like when I was throwing my leg and things like that. So,
how important do you think the process was to being able to reach your goal?
The most important, probably, when I think back to it, you know, like trusting that what the coach has said was the right play call, you know, and things like that.
Cool. You know, the reason why I want to go over this is you're already a champion. Let me be very clear about this, okay? Anything that we're going to ask you to do right here, you've already done. Does that make sense? It may just be for, like, Cutco, right? But you've already, like, overcame obstacles before. You've already been, you know, behind the $5. All the characteristics you need to do well in this job, you've already done. So I want you to know that you're already a champion. And anyway, so... I guess, like, first and foremost, you mind if I share some of the things that you would be able to, you know, some of the incentives that you would be able to get, you know, if you were to do $10,000?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. So the first thing is you would make $2,000. Dude, that's insane. What would you do with that money?
Pay my bills and save the rest, for sure. I might go out on this one time.
Of course, I think it's very, very important to celebrate. I mean, is there, give me another job where you can make $2,000 for 2 days on the job.
Not a chance.
You see why people like to go wall out their first 2 days?
Definitely.
Okay, cool. The next thing is getting, by the end of your first 2 days, you'll be at 30%. Dude, how cool would that be?
That'd be awesome. Yeah, I'm only at 20% right now, so.
And one of the big things, remember in training when I was talking about like working really, really hard, so at the end, kind of like how you were working out, like the health room Frank said. You start off with like a 50-pound dumbbell, right? And at the end, you do a 5-pound dumbbell, it's gonna be a lot lighter, right? You're gonna work a lot less and earn a lot more. does and Jenny does. That's why a lot of your friends are able to, you know, sell $1,000 of movements, like 2 or 3 appointments, and make $300. So do you see why that's important?
Yeah, definitely.
Okay, perfect. The next thing is, man, we have an opportunity for you to go on a limit back. Now let me build up this limit back with you, okay, real quick. So it's, you know, by Brian Stevenson. Now, if you don't know Brian Stevenson, this guy is like the biggest party animal in the whole world. Okay, like, I mean, literally, what happened on this limo night, stayed on limo night. I'm not going to tell you a little bit more, any more about it, just use your imagination, okay? All right, so, the next thing is you'll be able to win a President's Club, you work today's one job. Now, this is a signed recommendation letter from a $250 national market firm, basically saying, hey, CJ, if you ever need a job, let me know. How do you think that looks on your resume?
Like, really good. I don't think anything can stack it anymore.
Right?
That's awesome.
Yeah. By the way, there is no limit on how many you can win, but I mean, this is very impressive to win for a job. The next thing is you'll be invited to the Leadership Academy. Now, this is really, really, really cool. So we have this meeting right before SC1 and like SC2, where all the people over $10,000 in sales get the opportunity to meet Brian Stevenson and Drew Frank and, you know, all the division managers. And what happens is we have some of our top performers come, and like Julian Landry, they'll teach people how to sell bigger and all these different things as well. So you definitely get to, you know, learn more about like your skill sets, and also you're qualified to start being able to present like the cookware as well, which is also really, really cool. And then last but not least, okay, you have the opportunity to go field training with Alan Barber or Lauren Cole. Both are over $100,000 in sales, and what they're going to be able to teach you how to do is how to do service calls. Can you imagine what you would learn, right, like going on field training with, like, you know, Lauren Cole or you know, Alan Barber?
Yeah, I mean, they've been doing that. I can't believe they've sold over $100,000 from this product. It's crazy. Yeah. That'd be awesome.
And possibly even Julian, who's, you know, actually just hit the Hall of Fame. He's hit $1 million.
Oh, wow.
And then from there, you would also be on the quick track to be on the parent shows as well. So, remind me to talk to you a little bit about that. So, out of all those things that I just covered with you, what excites you the most?
The President's Club letter, Limo Night sounds really cool, and $2,000. Those are awesome.
Yeah. Okay, cool. So let me ask you this. Do you mind if I, you know, kind of tell you what it would take in order for you to achieve that?
Yeah, that would come out.
Cool, perfect. So I guess the first thing would be, you know, if you want to go ahead and take out a schedule real quick. Okay, cool. So I want to go ahead and put the team meeting into your schedule. So one thing that I'm really big on, guys, is 48-hour management. So as long as they come to the advanced training, right, from advanced training, then they come to the team meeting. From team meeting, right, they come to the Friday phone jam, and then from the Friday phone jam, they're gonna at least be there on either Sunday or Monday with the 11th hour list, or the last day of their fast start. If a kid comes to every single event, right, they're gonna hit 10K. I'm a really big believer in that. So anyway, I'm gonna put all of that in your schedule. Great. Now, the next thing is, all right, so I want you to write down this, 30 orders. I've never had a representative, and I've had 16 10K fast starters. I've never had a representative in the history of my career, ever, okay, have 30 orders and not do 10K. So that's no matter what. Now, for somebody like yourself, you may only need 20 or 15. You know, I know Joe already, he only had like 22. But no matter what, if you get 30, you're gonna hit 10K, okay? So put a big star by that. Okay, perfect. So make sure that you also write down the 11th hour list. So what is an 11th hour list? An 11th hour list is every single person that you've already sold to. We're gonna call them back at the end. Maybe also some like virtuals or anything like that. And the whole point is if you're behind on your goals, right? You maybe need like 1,000, anywhere from 1,000 to $3,000 on the last day. This list is how you're gonna do it. Matter of fact, John Carbosch, who graduated from Jesuit right before you, sold $7,000 the last week's fast start on 11th hour list. You know, Raphael Robert, who was at $4,000, his first, on the last day, sold $6,000 off of the 11th hour list. So you see why this is important?
Yeah, definitely.
Now, what I would do if I were you is I would create this list by at least, you know, Saturday. I know you probably want to hang out.